mouth food to come. If you read Numbers chapter 20 verse 8, God told Moses, people were complaining for water, no water anywhere. So I said, look, do you see the rock there? Tomorrow morning, gather all the people before the rock, and you look at the rock and you said, water, come out. That's all. That's all Moses should do. If he had done that, a huge reservoir of water, enough to feed 3 million people, would have come out of the rock. A river of water would have flowed and flowed and flowed from a small rock. You know, science tells us there are some water in rocks, but there are little tricks, tricklets, little drop here, little drop there. Natural water inside a rock will not flow abundantly to feed 3 million people. For that to happen, it is supernatural. The Bible says, you know, their water and their bread will be provided them in the last days. And you will do this. You will command water to come out. You will command water to be turned, poisoned water. Water's poisoned by the enemy, by chemical gases, by chemical waste. All the waters are polluted. How are you going to drink the water? You will touch the water. And you'll command the waters to turn into sweet drinking water, like what Elisha did, like what Moses did. The waters of Marah changed. You see, the entire molecular structure of the waters were changed. A polluted water, its molecules are different. So for the molecules of the water to be changed, to be drinking, means there is an entire chemical change that takes place in the water. That is creative, recreative miracles. Healings and recreative miracles to join limbs and raise the dead, those injured by the Antichrist army. You know, in a war, there are casualties on both sides, right? There's going to be casualties on both sides. So when the limbs are broken, the limbs are cut, what are you going to do? You get your hands cut off. And it's just dangling by one vein. Say, not a problem. Come here. Just take it. Poof. Fine. Go back. Go on doing your normal work. Does it sound comical? It's the truth. It's the truth. You know, even bullets cannot kill you. I once saw a vision. In this vision, I was leading a group of youths to war against the enemy. So all this bunch of youths, when I look at them, they appeared in their early 20s, not mid-20s. So I was like the captain leading them, you know, and we were in what looked like an old-fashioned English castle. You know, in the old-fashioned English castles, they have a drawbridge that you have to cross over. So we were on one end of the bridge to go over to the other side. And as I was leading the group, then came the enemy. And they all looked so huge and big-sized like Goliaths. And they all had all kinds of modern weapons, machine guns, grenades, this and that. And what does my team have? Swords. You know, by the time you swing a sword like that, 100 bullets will fly. Right? Bullets are faster than swords. Isn't it? So, and the enemy's group looks so fierce and threatening. And so intimidating. So when I came and stood there, we were about 30 feet away. And I thought for a moment, my God, we are outnumbered. My group was very small.